low. Jerry Jones, cause I'm the ball. Call in, let me hear your thought. Cut, Jack, yeah, flat on.
Ooh, it's that time. Time for the dopest sports show on radio to invade your airways. It's The Crush, streaming live on a Sensation Station Network and also broadcasted on WBLZSports.com. I am your humble co-host, E. Glaze. And with me as always, Maceo Hurd. I just found out Maceo can climb ropes and do pull-ups at the same time.
I tell the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth. So help me. Hey, man, Coach Carter, something wrong with that dude, man.
Did you see? I saw that. I'm like, no, what?
I ain't made it to the top yet. I'm halfway there.
Did you see how crazy you get up there?
That's the drill, but you ought to see the kids do it.
Oh, they do it just like that?
Oh, man, they get up there, and then, so you got to climb up, then you got to do 10 pull-ups, and then you got to get your legs, swing your legs up.
Yeah.
I'm halfway up the rope. I can scrape the thing, but I just come on back down. It's all good.
Look, you get up there, though. That's all that matters, man. You're getting there.
I'm almost there, man.
What episode is this, Wendy?
29.
Episode 29. How you doing, Wendy, today?
I'm good today.
I saw your girl scored today.
She scored. She scored today. It's her first middle school game.
Go ahead.
Game. I know.
Shout out to
Woodward Academy.
Yeah, she trying.
Yeah, she better be scoring buckets
over there.
Then it was 3-0. She scored one. I said, why you ain't score more?
Yeah.
Boy,
I tell you.
Some parents, I tell you.
We got a great show for you guys today, man. We got a lot of topics, man. One of them that just jumped off the board for me, man, was that hot topic that you got going, boy. What we got to talk about today, Mason?
Man, well, you know, the hot topic today, of course, Kevin Garnett. He talked about how AAU is ruining the state of basketball. So we're gonna get into that.
We got to.
It's hot, you know, because
you posted that, we got a comment about that.
We got a lot of comments about it.
There was one in particular that kind of jumped out at me.
Mm-hmm.
The positive of AAU.
It's a case by case thing.
Exactly.
But man, listen, we're gonna tear this thing down today because we got a coach in the building.
Yeah.
So we're gonna get kind of the coach's perspective.
And you know your coach too, because he got the long sleeve up under the short sleeve.
Oh yeah, man. That's the coach look, baby.
And he ain't really warm, but he ain't really cool. But he got to keep the body at a good temperature.
Well, you know, coaches wear long sleeves all the time.
All the time. I don't know why. We just do it.
I don't know. The kids would ask me every day in the summertime, Coach, why you got a long sleeve? I'm like, man, I'm actually cooler than y'all.
Yeah, I'm good.
Yeah.
It doesn't affect me.
Trying to keep the sun off me.
Yeah, man.
That's what I'm really trying to do.
I mean, it's just the look, man. You can always tell the coach that he coaching. He got that look on.
Yeah. Because, you know, I usually work on my tan when I was out there in the summertime. I wanted to keep it, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. It's Wendy looked at me sideways like, your tan. Yeah. Yeah, I like to keep it light, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Okay.
Almost crispy. Oh, yeah.
Not quite there.
One shade to the left of crispy.
Yeah.
So they got a chart. They got crispy at the end.
Because you know, when the weather changes, you know, I get light skinned again. So,
okay.
Yeah, without a doubt.
You turn into Maceo Senior all of a sudden.
Man, hey, man. I keep asking that dude, man. Hey, man. Why y'all so light skinned?
Hey, man, I don't even know where to go with that one.
Shout out to my dad.
Leave that one alone.
Yeah, let that go. Hey, man, what else we got to talk about today? We got some recruiting. We got the coaching here, man. And look, man, this is for you, show. What number can they call us at, Mason?
Hey, man, y'all can call the show at 678-613-5857. Or feel free just to share it. Share this information with everybody, man. Because once Coach Pope go in, the walls might come crumbling down tonight after Coach Pope get off his mic, man. We're going to church tonight.
That's our Cricket Wireless hotline. Go cricketwireless.com to find out about all of there.
You see her handwriting on the sign?
No.
That's so pretty.
She always got extra.
Only probably because of the camera, the HD camera on tonight. So she
hey, let me get this out. Cricketwireless.com. Cricket Wireless, something to smile about. Look, what is that?
Did she just read me?
Did she read us like that?
Wow.
Hey, man, we'll be right back.
Vince Lombardi. Hardy once said that it's hard to be aggressive when you're confused. Some of us think that taking our lives to the next level, both personally and professionally, is a confusing and complicated process. Guess what? It's not, and I can prove it. My book, Truisms, will show you how living your life by rules that are so self-evident and obvious, you'll say, I knew that. This powerful yet short, detailed bestseller is on sale right now, under $10. Go to MichaelMcFadden.com. That's MichaelMcFadden.com, and let Truisms help you to the next level.
Hi, this is Terry Crews, actor, former football player, and father of five. I'm also an expert on drama. There's the good kind that comes with having a house full of kids, and there's silly drama like the drama around my percolating pectorals. And then there's the drama you can skip.
Skip the drama that comes with not having your high school diploma or equivalency. Find free adult education classes near you and finish your diploma. Visit finishyourdiploma.org. That's finishyourdiploma.org.
And lead the drama to actors like me.
Brought to you by the Dollar General Literacy Foundation and the Ed Council.
Okay, so five tacos of cheese and a large soda, that's $10,012. Please drive around.
Wait, 10,000 what?
It's obvious you're buzzed and driving.
I've only had a few. I'm fine.
Yeah, the food's $12, but getting pulled over for buzz driving could cost you around $10,000 in fines, legal fees, and increased insurance rates. Please drive around. Actually, just park and come in.
Nothing kills a buzz like getting pulled over for buzz driving, because buzz driving is drunk driving. Brought to you by the National Highway Traffic Safety Administration and the Ad Council.
Uncle Dan?
Mom?
Dad?
If you store your guns properly, so not just anyone can get to them.
I'll feel safer when I'm playing outside.
Safer when walking home.
Safer when my friends come over.
As your neighbor, I'll feel safer.
As a school teacher, I'll feel safer.
We'll all feel safer.
Your family, friends, and neighbors are all counting on you. If you own a gun, you have a full-time responsibility. When you aren't using it, be sure it can't get into the hands of curious children, troubled teenagers, a thief, or anyone else who might misuse it. Remember, always lock it up. For more information on firearm storage safety, visit ncpc.org. This message brought to you by the National Crime Prevention Council, the Bureau of Justice Assistance, and the Ad Council.
You know you're listening to the dopest show on the airwaves, right?
You're my boy!
It's the crush.
On SSNATL.com.
Thank you, sir.
Hot topics.
We're going to some hot topics brought to you by Dr. Kevin Dance. If your smile hasn't become to you, it should be coming to us. Dr. Kevin Dance has been practicing dentistry for 16 years in beautiful Southwest Atlanta. His office is located at 3752 Cascade Road, Suite 190. Complete family dentistry with everything you need in one office. Call and make an appointment at 678-836-2118. That's 678-836-2118. All right, Mace, what we got for the hot topic today?
Hey, man, our hot topic today, man, is Kevin Garnett. He says AAU basketball has ruined the game. Fair or foul comment? We're going to start with Coach Kevin Pope. Kevin Pope, how you doing today first, sir?
I'm doing good. How you doing,
man? I'm doing good, brother. We're doing good. So what you think about Kevin Garnett making these statements?
Kind of up in the air on that. I play AAU back in the day with Outlaw.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know about – I think he's talking more about the situation with how the game is being played.
Mm-hmm.
But the benefits of it is, man, a lot of the kids that don't get an opportunity to get a lot of exposure due to, you know, coaches and in the regular schools and stuff like that get a great opportunity, you know. So that's how I look at it. But I know, you know, the game itself is kind of saturated to me. It's not like it used to be.
Mm.
You know, everybody's, you know, styling and profiling, no defense. You know, just don't take pride in the game like they used to. And it's like that in the AAU as well, you know.
Blaze, I know what you're going to say first and foremost.
You know how I feel about AAU.
Yeah,
I'm not a fan of it.
You're looking for post players.
Yeah, because we got too many stretch fives.
Stretch fours.
Stretch fours, sir. Stretch fives. 6'11", 260 shooting threes, I got a problem with. But it bothers me to the pack. And point. If AAU was to do what it intentionally originally wanted to do, was to give kids a chance to get their skills better,
mm-hmm.
I would be all for it.
Mm-hmm.
But AAU to me now looks like it's a hustle. You're playing 100-some games. You go into a game. You go to an AAU game tournament. They playing like 1,000 games a day. Ain't nobody trying to pass. Ain't nobody setting picks. It's just
got to get mine.
Got to get my 30. Mm. You know what I'm saying? And now I know some out there, but it looks like they're almost as powerful as head coaches in high school.
I would say probably more powerful.
Because that bothers me.
That when the last time you seen a bunch of college coaches in a basketball gym?
Exactly.
And Wendy, I asked you this because you guys have a young fellow over there at Langston Hughes who's getting a lot of interest. Mm-hmm. How many college coaches have been over to Langston Hughes?
They don't come to the games like that anymore.
Not like they used to.
Not like they used to. Now, when you go to Wheeler, the gym is always full. Now, we'll say that much. They're always there.
Yeah. I would have to agree with that.
And if you think about it, we got these guys going to AAU and doing all that. So, they're pretty much being picked by colleges in AAU time. So, they aren't. What are we producing? Look at Ben Simmons. Is he actually a real good player right now?
Now, this is what troubles me when I hear Kevin Garnett and I hear Kobe talk about how bad AAU is. Because we know AAU is almost like tennis shoe driven.
Yeah.
Who are they paid by?
Yeah.
They're Nike guys.
Yeah.
A lot of the AAU kids wear Kobe shoes that are $225. Mm-hmm. Everybody knows that a lot of the AAU, the elite AAU, driven by Adidas, Under Armour, Nike.
Yeah.
So I hear Kevin Garnett, but at the same time, like, you kind of got to be careful, KG, because, I mean, I think you still getting a check from Nike.
You know, so this is my opinion. I'm not for or against AAU. I do know that a lot of now are pretty much recruitment for basketball
is done
goes through AAU.
Exactly.
I mean, they come to some of the college, I mean, to the high school games, but it's you don't see them as much as you used to. What I will say, I think the issue is now is the handlers. That's the problem. That's the problem in AAU right now. They it's always a hustle. It's like, what can you give me if I bring you this kid?
Exactly.
And so now that's also turning into an issue at the high school level because kids are transferring around to play with the kids that they're playing with in the summer.
Yep. I lost my quarterback at Mays because of that.
So, you know, I think that's the issue now with the AAU programs. I think that there's some good things going on still in AAU basketball, but I think that is what's becoming the problem.
Because we had,
especially in the boys' arena.
When you posted
starting to see it in the girls too.
Yeah, and that's true too. You posted that when you posted that about Kevin. A guy said, "Hey, my son became a little bit better and made the varsity team because of his AAU skills." Mm-hmm. That's a good story. That's a case-by-case thing.
Yeah.
But if you, like you say, Wendy, if I'm playing with my homeboy and we're going to make this powerhouse school around the corner, am I really playing? And I guess I'm so old school that I hate to see the high school coaches lose their power.
And I think it's the fundamental part that he's talking
about.
Because
it was supposed to be made for kids to do skills, right? Like, and when they play games, but like that was to get your skill work and all that other stuff together, in addition to high school. But you know what I'm saying? In the off season, that was like your time to do all those things. And so, I think it seems like some of that's being taken away from it.
Yeah.
And I think that's the point Kevin was trying to make.
Set up though, I know when we were young, and I'm looking at a lot of guys now. The kids that really need development is not playing AAU. It's the elite players.
Which kind of brings me to my point.
But they can't get on the national. They can't get on that national schedule. That travel.
I made that post early about. See, with all of this, it's only 1%.
Very few
of elite kids. Like I know two kids who get flown around the country by Nike. Everybody don't get that treatment.
Yeah.
They don't get that. So I think, as a whole, I think KG was just basically saying, you look at the skill set of all these kids now. You see it in college, and you definitely see it in the pros. Some of the kids, like we were talking about Ingram yesterday.
Yeah.
Like, he could have did another year of college.
Yeah. Right.
But you understand why he finna be the number two overall pick. Why am I going to class at Duke?
Well, right. And two, it's like he was saying, it's a sense of entitlement. And I've seen that across the board with kids at schools, period. They think that there's no work to be done. It's just going to happen for them.
Yep. That's true.
Ooh, boy.
It's just.
So that's just it. And I'm going to tell you, that's in every sport.
And like you were saying, handlers, man, it's looking like more of high school sports is becoming pro sports.
You got to talk to my man.
Right.
To my mans and them.
You 16. I can't talk to you. Nah, man. Coach over there say, I can't do
this. Well, like I say, I've been to a few games, and it seemed like the kids listen to
somebody across the court.
Across the court.
Okay.
As opposed to,
Hey, man.
She just waved her hand again.
Right. We didn't get snapped at this time.
Yeah. Hey, man. We'll be right back.
I am an American soldier.
I'm a warrior and a member of a team. I serve the people of the United States and live the Army values.
I will always place mission first.
I will never accept defeat.
I will never accept defeat.
I will never quit.
I will never leave a fallen comrade.
I am disciplined.
I am disciplined. Physically and mentally tough.
Trained and proficient in my warrior task and drill.
I am an expert, and I am a professional.
I stand ready to deploy, engage, and destroy the
enemies of the United States of America in close combat.
I am a guardian of freedom and the American way of life.
I am an American soldier.
I am an American soldier.
I am an American soldier.
They're strong, and there's Army Strong. See what it takes at GoArmy.com.
Kellenders knows that you may not have time to roll out dough for a perfectly flaky crust that's made from scratch. Or enough time to mix vegetables with all white meat chicken and a homemade gravy. She knows you may not have a moment to crimp the edges of your favorite chicken pot pie. But Marie Kellenders does. And when she's done, all you need to do is find time to grab someone special. Sit down and savor. Marie Kellenders, it's time to savor.
When I grow up, I want to be a new pair of blue jeans.
When I grow up, I want to be a kid's first computer.
I want to be a warm place on a cold day.
I want to be a football stadium.
I want to be a bike that races around the country.
I want to be a bench on a forest trail.
When I grow up, I don't want to be a piece of garbage. And if you recycle me, I won't be.
Give your garbage another life. Recycle. Learn how at iwanttoberecycled.org. Brought to you by Keep America Beautiful and the Ad Council.
JBT 700 Miami Circle 30324. It's not a chain, it's a chain reaction.
Invest $49 a month at a real gym.
For more info, go to facebook.com/jeansbodytech.
This is Amari Batman Carroll. You listen to The Crush, the only sports radio show that they're going to keep it real in the A on Sensation Station Network.
Welcome to That Crushing Interview, brought to you by Oracy Software. The Oracy team is committed to providing full lifecycle support for developing, testing, and delivering market-driven products. Oracy models is when a customer engages one of us, they engage all of us. Go to Oracy.com, O-R-A-S-I.com, for more information. Make sure you got to give them the formal introduction.
Hey, man, right? Coming to the microphone right here, man. A guy who really loves these kids, man, if there's no doubt about his level of commitment when coaching high school athletes, man. We're going to get all into that real quick, man. Kevin Pope to the microphone. What's up, Coach?
What's going on?
What's happening, brother?
Hey, man, I'm great.
Now, Coach, before we start, I want you to break down, because, you know, we talk a lot. I want you to break down the three levels of kids when you say when it comes to recruit. You got three levels.
Yeah, three levels of kids. I got your executive level. Those are the D1 kids, meaning they constantly train their bodies. They constantly doing what they need to do in the classroom, and they're constantly a humble kid. They're always doing the right things. Those are the executive level. Then we got your managerial level. Your managerial level is your D2 guys, your NAIA guys. Their vitals are not what the D1's looking at for their size, but they got a lot of heart. They play well, and they do well in their classroom. They meet the criteria. But then we got your working class. That's your JUCO that didn't want to do no schoolwork, or the ones that's after that last game, you're going to be crying because that's your last game you ever play in pass, unless you, like you say, go semi-pro. That's what I tell my parents when they first come in. You know, you can choose the level that you want to be on when you first come in with your player. You know, you come in, that's what we do. So we got your executive level, your managerial level, your working class level.
What's your highest percentage?
For me? I ain't boasting, but we got some executive level.
Okay, all right.
We got some executive level.
You know, I thought you would say, hey, man, we got that work class before, bro.
We're trying to alleviate that.
But when we talk about the the managerial level kids. Mm-hmm. This is what most kids gonna be.
Yeah.
Most kids are gonna fit into mm-hmm. this because yep. everybody's not an elite prospect.
Correct.
Everybody's not an elite prospect. Correct. How hard is that to get parents to understand that, listen, this just not where you are athletically or grade wise?
Well, honestly, it comes with programming. You got to program the parents. For instance, you know, your son comes in and he's 5'7", and he's playing corner. He in 11th grade, he weigh 152 pounds.
Mm.
Not quite going to be a D1 guy, and he run a 4.7. It's not going to happen. But the fact of it is, I just tell our parents that it's still life if he choose to. You know, we got some good NAIA schools, because at the bottom line, we got to start looking at the NFL dream all the time and look at finishing college, or getting the opportunity to go into college and getting that degree and being able to walk out of there, you know, what I call your rites of passage. I tell all my players that your rites of passage for me is to go to your mom and dad and say, listen, no matter what, I'm going to make sure my college is taken care of. I'm going to take care of that. So when I leave out of there, I'll be debt free. You know, like a lot of players that leave out, I mean, a lot of kids, they take out these loans and, you know, no disrespect to my wife, but them loans are crazy.
I never had a loan.
Sally Mae Vicious. What's her name now? What you say her name is? You say she changed her name? She still Sally Mae?
I don't know. Mine federal. I got them Staffords. That's okay. You know, you do the 120 public service loan forgiveness. I'm in there. That's why I teach. Okay. That's why I work at the school now.
Oh, okay.
But see, I try to give them all the information, you know, some of the long-term effects of, you know, just get to school. Get to school, please. Just get to school. Get an opportunity to get yourself in a good position to get a decent job and a good living. You know, if anything comes after that, that's a plus.
Icing on the cake.
That's a plus.
Yeah. Icing on the cake.
Yeah. Coach, what is summer of, if you're getting, is it, what is when, you, and I'm not going, I don't want to go down to the lower level, because there are some kids right there that do get a little knucklehead and stuff like that. Mm-hmm. What are some of the main things that you try to get to them? I mean, everybody got aspiration, but sometimes you just got to tell these kids, look, man, you got talent, you got all this, but your work effort, it's got to get better, man. What do you work on? Do you get those, what we call not managerial, what was the lower level again?
Working class.
Working class. When you get the working class, man, how do you, it has to be frustrating sometimes to get them.
Well, you give them a life principle. And the life principle, if you want to get out of this working class, what are you going to do to get out of the working class? You got to start living a regimented life. So you have to start looking at what the managerial and the executive people are doing. You know what I mean? So I tell, you know, a lot of time, man, a kid that's not working, the reason why he's not working, because he's not around the people that are working. Mm-hmm. He's around people that are being lazy. So like a lot of players, I tell my players, I say, now, look at this guy. And you wonder why he got 30 offers. If you want an opportunity to be even in that level or be in that stratosphere, work with him.
Go hang out with
Stop
him.
Stop hanging out with these guys. These guys ain't doing nothing. But these are the guys you choose. Then that's what the outcome. Karma. You get what you put out. Bottom line.
Boy, this boy preaching right here. And what's funny, Coach, you know, I got this motto, love who love you.
Absolutely.
And so many kids, it's like they're chasing. It's like, oh, but I want to go here. And I'm always like, well, that school don't even know you're alive. Mm-hmm. But these schools do know you're alive. Just the gamble of that. What's your take on that, Cole?
Again, love who love you, man. I mean, you said it in a nutshell. I never understood this. I've had that experience so many times where I call the parent and I tell them, listen, so-and-so, Savannah State wants you right now. They love the kid. Well, Coach, what conference that in? That's the MEAC conference. You know, well, what is that? Because, you know, can you call Georgia? I said, no, Georgia will call you. You don't call Georgia. You see what I'm saying? So, but then you have to explain to them, man, listen, this is a good school. This is a school that wants your son. So why are you out here trying to, you know, be with somebody that don't want to be with you? That's what I tell my kids. I say, you know, you trying to talk to this girl. And this girl ain't studying, but this girl over here, she helping you with your homework. She, you know, man, she always inspiring you.
One minute, Coco. Hold slow. Slow down, Coco.
Too many flashing lights, Coco. We'll be right back.
JBT 700 Miami Circle 30324. It's not a chain, it's a chain reaction.
Invest $49 a month at our real gym.
For more info, go to facebook.com/
Jeans Body Tech.
Adopt US Kids presents Multiple Choice Parenting.
You've accidentally cut your daughter's bangs unevenly. Do you A, line things up a centimeter from her hairline?
Man.
No, sweatbands are so hot right now. Everyone's wearing them. Like that basketball player and that other basketball player.
B, get spiritual.
Mom, where did all the mirrors go?
A reflection could never capture our true selves.
Huh?
Beauty is within.
See, look on the bright side.
Less time blow drying, more time texting.
Or D, show empathy.
Mom, you really don't have
Ta-da! Twinsies!
I kinda love it. As a parent, there are no perfect answers. But you don't have to be perfect to be a perfect parent. Thousands of teens in foster care will love you just the same.
For more information on how you can adopt, visit AdoptUSKids.org. A public service announcement from the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services, Adopt U.S. Kids, and the Ad Council.
Vince Lombardi once said that it's hard to be aggressive when you're confused. Some of us think that taking our lives to the next level, both personally and professionally, is a confusing and complicated process. Guess what? It's not, and I can prove it. My book, Truisms, will show you how living your life by rules that are so self-evident and obvious, you'll say, I knew that. This powerful yet short, detailed bestseller is on sale right now, under $10. Go to michaelmcfadden.com. That's michaelmcfadden.com, and let Truisms help you to the next level.
This is Bobby Yaller from the Ohio State. I'm kicking with the Crush on Sensation Station Network.
Hey, we're back, man. Hey, what year you went to South Carolina State?
I went South Carolina State from, I played 92 to 95, there from 92 to 96.
I think I know some people that were with you with that. Shout out to Coach Oglesby, Cedric Oglesby, man, the kicking clinic, man. Shout out to you, man. We're still here with Coach. Coach, let me ask you this, man. What's that thrill like, man, when you're coaching these kids and they're doing exactly what they need to do, man, and then signing day come and you say...
Nah, he cried on signing day.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying, but he hit your chest, man. How you feel when that day comes, Coach, man?
Oh, man, it's the best feeling in the world because you felt like you accomplished your goal. You did what you told the kid he was going to do, you know. It's just a manifestation of, you know, everything you said. When you know, we always do a thing called we going to claim it, all right? This is what you want to do. So in 3 to 4 years, you know, depending on when you get there, this is the goal, and when you get it, you see them up on that stage, and they get it, man. It's overwhelming. Yeah. It really is. It's a great.
And see the smiles on their faces, man. Just man. Like they going next level, man.
Oh yeah,
that's a good feeling.
Oh yeah.
He was in there, but he got choked up.
Yeah, man. he got choked up.
It was one kid that y'all just don't understand, man. I've been around, get choked up again, man. Hey, man, this kid, man, is 5'8". He 220 pounds. He played with me in rec ball at Truth, and he came over with me, and I threw him in the fire because, you know, when I got there, the program wasn't very good, and I played 9 freshmen on defense, and he was one of the ones, and he went through a lot. He went from a 1-8-1 season. He came back the next year. We went 4-6. The next year we went 6-4. So his senior year, he get to the state semifinals and then get a scholarship. He got a 3.5 GPA. I mean, the kid is just unbelievable. He had 676 tackles in his career.
Good Lord.
You know, and to see him get there, to go to college,
years.
Man.
Yeah.
And I'm talking about, you talking about loyal, man. He never missed a practice. He never missed a workout. He just the epitome of greatness, man.
Mm.
You know, and the unfortunate that, you know, he'd have been at a Michigan State if he'd have been 6 feet.
Right.
Right.
He was just that kind of kid. So for him to get anywhere, you know what I mean? And was appreciative too.
Yeah. Oh yeah. And without a doubt.
That's the thing.
That meant
you best believe when that college get him, they're gonna
so
be appreciative.
Shout out to your Elwood Thump Smith. My man.
That last name what?
Elwood Thump Smith.
That name right there.
That's it. Thump.
With a name like that?
Yeah.
Now, we had this thing we always talk about during this recruiting process. The eye test is real. No matter, I mean, and it's not nothing we came up with. It's just how colleges look at kids. Yeah. Just talk to how true that is.
It's very true. You know, when scouts come in, the first thing they do is they stand up next to them. They go to touching the arms, and, you know, they always telling us what they're looking for. Hey, coach, we're looking for our corners got to be, you know, 6 feet or better. You know, our D linemen, we want them 6'2", you know, 255. You know, they give us the vitals that they're looking for and, you know, hope we can accommodate them, you know. But that's what they look for within, you know, within these different, you know, teams and different, especially in the Power Five. They looking for big player that can run and all of that kind of stuff. And it's tough, but that's just the reality, man. It's the reality. That's what they're looking for.
Now, go ahead, Coach. Go ahead, Glenn.
And when you – we talked about it a little bit earlier in having actual conversation with kids. I can't believe you're a fan of them.
Really?
Having a conversation with kids who they don't want to go to where that – who loving them. Mm-hmm. I mean, how do you get to them? I mean, because, you know, we see stories where kids hold out and say, man, I didn't go to this school, and they look disappointed. But appreciation of where you're going. You know, like your man Thump Smith, which will be my favorite name going forward. So I will love that name going forward. To see when you see it, but you see a kid, oh man, I ain't going here. Getting through to these kids, man, it's a privilege to play on that next level. It's not given.
Yeah, it's not privilege. And you know, you have to talk to kids at their level. You know, we can't talk to like we're talking. And you have to really give them in detail the situation. And what I do in detail with them is just let them know, okay, you may not gotten the school that you wanted, but let's look on the bright side. You're in a situation right now that you're going to get a college education. They're going to pay for it. And you're going to get an opportunity to get a college degree and get a chance to play football at least 4 more years of your life.
All right.
How can you turn that down?
Because when it's over, it's over.
Because when it's over, it's over. Yeah.
And you
when the last like, down is played.
Look, and you be like me, like, man, if I had one more play.
Listen, everybody know this. Me and Coach Pope talk about, you remember your last game? What, you remember the date?
Yeah. Oh, I don't remember the date, but I remember the last play. I remember the last play. Fred Lane ran, jumped on top of me and scored a touchdown. I'm like, and I remember that play just like it was yesterday, and I'm like, I should have tackled him.
Recipe.
We come back, man. Coach, we're going to jump into some topics. We want you to jump in with us. And Wendy, I thought we were cool up in here, but she didn't.
Man, she tripping, man.
Yeah, we'll be right back.
Driving has a rhythm all its own. Don't wreck it with a text. Before you get behind the wheel, silence your phone. Or better yet, designate a texter. For more text-free driving tips, visit stoptextstoprex.org. Brought to you by the Ad Council and the National Highway Traffic Safety Administration.
Great leaders aren't born. They're made, and not just anywhere. They're made in special places by special, qualified trainers in places like the Academy of Creative Coaching. The Academy of Creative Coaching is an international certification program with courses in health and wellness coaching, spiritual coaching, relationship coaching, executive coaching, life coaching, and cultural competency coaching. Courses are online, hybrid, or face-to-face. The Academy of Creative Coaching is empowering coaches to empower the world. Make a positive change in yourself and the world. Go to academyofcreativecoaching.com.
Okay, so 5 tacos of cheese and a large soda, that's $10,012. Please drive around.
Wait, 10,000 what?
It's obvious you're buzzed and driving.
I've only had a few. I'm fine.
Yeah, the food's $12, but getting pulled over for buzz driving could cost you around $10,000 in fines, legal fees, and increased insurance rates. Please drive around. Actually, just park and come in.
Nothing kills a buzz like getting pulled over for buzz driving, because buzz driving is drunk driving. Brought to you by the National Highway Traffic Safety Administration and the Ad Council.
Hey, Crush fans, I'm Tanisha Fernandez. You're listening to The Crush on Sensation Station Network.
Mics be hot. She just putting them on
hot. She just put the mic hot. She can at least... Hey, man, she tripped.
Yeah, she snapped when it's time to go, but she don't snap when the mic hot. Hey, man, what you got for us,
man? Hey, man, so one of our favorite topics we always talk about, National Signing Day. Mm-hmm.
don't be fooled by the rankings. When they bring these rankings out, we say all the time, at least let the kids get on campus and see what they made of. So what Bleacher Report did, they went back to 2015, mm-hmm. and they re-ranked the top classes, you know, after they saw the kids play. So at number five, in this list, they did a top 10, but, you know, we ain't got time for all this. We're just going to do the top five. So at number five is Alabama, who was originally ranked number two in this class. Out of this class, 2015, Calvin Ridley was a, you know, he turned to a ball. He got 161 catches, 14 touchdowns. Minka Fitzpatrick became All-American.
Yeah.
Damian Harris finally became a 1,000-yard rusher.
Finally.
That's it from that class right now. Wow. Nobody else has contributed.
And which year is this game?
This was 2015.
2015.
At number four, Florida State. They were originally ranked number 11.
Really?
I want y'all to understand how wrong recruiting services be. Mm-hmm. So, out of this class, they had Derwin James, he a star, before the injury. DeAndre Francois.
Francois, oh, well.
He was freshman of the year.
Yeah, we know about Francois.
Tavares McFadden led the nation
in
interception.
Yeah.
Not to mention the other two- and three-star kids that nobody knew who are contributing to this class. Now, remember, they were ranked number 11 in 2015. Mm-hmm. These people be wrong, man. Texas is at number three.
Really?
They were originally ranked number seven. Anthony Wheeler, Brecken Hager, Malik Jefferson, all top three in tackles in the Big 12.
Can I be petty for a minute?
Sure.
So now that class gets taken over by...
Right.
Keep it going.
Connor Williams is All-American. Now, this was Charlie Strong's first class.
I know. That's what I'm saying.
Right.
And when he... keep
right.
it going.
This the kicker. Clemson is at number two. Originally ranked number 15.
Wow.
10 of 11 kids they signed in this class contributed to the national championship. They only had one kid out of this class. They only signed 11 in this class. 10 contributed, one transferred, and he was the highest rated recruit that transferred in 2015. And number one on this list, and they still number one, USC.
Because
USC, Sam Donald, Ronald James, all those guys contribute. They won the Rose Bowl, and they're probably going to be preseason number one.
Yeah.
Coach, talk about reinforce how don't worry about them stars next to your name.
No, you never should worry about them stars. Because, see, can I be real with you?
Bam, that's what we
Listen,
do.
The people that put these stars out here didn't play. They come out here, man, they write this stuff, or they listen to something we say, oh, this kid is going to be this. And then they'll go back and write verbatim what you say. It ain't even good journalism. I'm just being real. And then they'll come out there in the shorts, and they'll come to these camps and while you're in shorts and watch you run around in shorts. I keep stressing, in shorts. You know what I mean? And they say these boys are all they supposed to be this great ball player. But then it's a different when you put them pads on.
Yeah.
But like I say, a lot of these guys that are ranking these guys, they don't really know the game. They don't really know what to look for. They basically going off of, you know, kids performing at a camp or basically what somebody said. That's bottom line.
And this was funny. When we covered the True 19 game, Glaze, he got to see, him and Winnie got to see firsthand a lot of the guys, the Rusty Manziels and all.
Where do we end up? Where do all of us end up?
Oh,
end up.
Away from them players. I'm through with them.
Waste of time.
Waste of time.
What's your thought? Because I'm pissed off about the Texas thing. But can we
about what Manziel just went on? You know, the thing is, like, again, like Coach said, these rankings, these stars, all this stuff, like kids get all caught up in that, and it doesn't matter. When you get to school, you got to prove yourself all over again. None of that even matters anymore. And so, you know, I just think that it gives people a false sense of what their abilities are. And like you said, they're running around on, you know, looking at kids in shorts at 707s and stuff. That's not even, they're not in full pads, not a real game. Like, is it truly accurate what they're doing?
That's why I posted that earlier when I was talking to those coaches today. Hey, man, they look at game film. Dog. They not looking at no combine stuff. They're not looking at that.
We want you to be able to run, but what you going to do with it in the game? Mm. Everybody can run. You know, a lot of people can run fast when nothing's up against you.
When you but got all that
Drake
gear
just
on,
got, you can just run straight line.
When you out there by yourself, 707, you go across the middle a lot easier when you ain't got no pads.
That's all I'm saying. So, like, it's a false sense of exactly. what is really going on. Yeah.
You know what bothered me? The guys out there who make the ranking don't look athletic.
At all. At all.
I'm like, I'll tell the guy, I'll point out Glay. Oh, now that's 24/7 right there. That's Scout.
Sure. So I'm like,
Glay was like, kind of like, yeah, nah, he just got a camera.
I mean, it was absolutely. Like,
he just got a camera.
They ain't never touched the football.
But
never.
And they the ones putting stars. Here we go. Man, we got to take a break.
I'm going to start giving out stars too.
Leaders aren't born, they're made. And not just anywhere. They're made in special places by special, qualified trainers. In places like the Academy of Creative Coaching. The Academy of Creative Coaching is an international certification program with courses in health and wellness coaching, spiritual coaching, relationship coaching, executive coaching, life coaching, and cultural competency coaching. Courses are online, hybrid, or face-to-face. The Academy of Creative Coaching is empowering coaches to empower the world. Make a positive change in yourself and the world. Go to academyofcreativecoaching.com.
So, I'm a dog, and I just got adopted by this new human guy, and I'm starting to wonder how he got along without me. I mean, okay, something as simple as walking around the block. He's got this leash thing, and he puts me on one end and him on the other, and I'm just taking him around. I think he's afraid of getting lost. Without that leash and me guiding him along, I don't think he'd find his way back home. But it's kind of cute.
A person is the best thing to happen to a shelter pet. Be that person. Adopt. Brought to you by the Ad Council and the ShelterPetProject.org.
Green light.
Hey, girl.
School zone.
I'm getting hungry.
Car changing lanes.
You want to meet me for pizza?
Stop sign. Intersection clear.
Yeah.
Street.
Pizza sounds good.
Ball in street?
Girl in street!
It's hard to concentrate on two things at once, like texting and driving. Stop the text. Stop the wrecks. How will you stop texting and driving? Tell us at StopTextStopWrecks.org. Brought to you by the National Highway Traffic Safety Administration and the Ad Council.
This is big business. This is the American way.
Station Network.
See ya.
This is Tracy Hutchins with CBS 46 News. You're listening to The Crush on Sensation Station Network.
Yes, indeed, man. We're back here with Coach Kevin Pope. Right now, the most important part to this piece in recruiting, these academics, man. Hey, here we go. Hey, Wendy, let's get these SAT, ACT dates and fees, man. Y'all need to get a test score on the books, everybody.
Yeah, immediately. It's off season for football, basketball. It's slowly coming to an end. So now's a good time to start looking at these test dates. But so our next test date coming up is SAT, and it's going to be March 11th. Now, you need to register for it without a penalty, late fee, by February 28th. Okay, so you got to register by next week, Tuesday. So you got a little less than a week. Now, if you need a waiver, go to your counselor. You should. Most people do qualify for a waiver one way or another. So at least go by there and ask for it. If not, the fee for the SAT is $45. I would say to go ahead and write your essay the first time, because once you write the essay, you really don't need to pay for it again.
Mm-hmm.
Schools want to know that you have written an essay, but that you don't need to do it every time. And so the fee with the essay is $57. Make sure you get the there's a score report that you can ask for that's gives you a detailed score report. Go ahead and click on that too. It is free. Get that. Because if you need any type of help, the person that's helping you is probably going to want that information.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? ACT is coming up. ACT is going to be April 8th. Registration deadline is March the 3rd. For the past few years, I just saw this on Twitter today. ACT put this out. For the past few years, they've only done 6 days per year. Next year, they're going up, and they're going to add a seventh date, and they're actually going to put them in the summer.
Oh.
So ACT now will have a June 9th, 2018. This is for next year. And then a July 14th, 2018. So they're adding an extra test date, and it's going to actually be in the summertime, which is good.
Probably the best time for the kids.
I'm just trying to say.
Yeah.
So that you won't have that opportunity this year. ACT only has one this summer. It's going to be June 10th. So if you're a 10th grader, you need to be registered for that June 10th, which means you need to register by May the 5th for ACT. For SAT, there's a June 3rd test date, and you need to be registered by May 9th. And that's going to be for those people who are sophomores, especially, who want to take it after the completion of their second year in high school.
Okay. Coach, let me ask you this real quick, Coach. How soon do you tell kids they need to get that test score on the book?
Ninth grade. Ninth grade.
When do you say that too?
I say ninth grade, definitely by your 10th grade year. Don't wait until after that to take it for the first time, because if not, you already behind.
Yeah.
Already.
And, Coach, just talk to the parents about how important it is to get this score, because now that's all, everybody coming in, they just talking about grades and test scores first and foremost before they look at anything else.
Right. Well, yeah, definitely. You definitely want to have your scores in place before anything, because when a scout first come in, he's going to do this. This is how it goes. He sits down and he said, "Coach, I want to see your prospects." Once they look at the film, before they even want to see you, the first thing they say, "Well, let me get the transcript." When they get the transcript, they're going to review it right there. If it looks like it's not even worth their time, it's over. So you'll never get that opportunity. And then they're going to ask for the test score. So, you know, we have them already ready for them, and that's how we do it. So that's when your process starts right there, and it's over. And that happens in the school as soon as scout get there.
Now, Wendy has this theory about kids taking the test during the season. She don't think that's a good idea.
I agree with her.
Mm-hmm.
It's tough. You come off, you know, we had kids that come off a game, and then they got to get right back up.
And be somewhere at 7:45.
And stand in line.
And then you got to sit still for between 3 to 4 hours.
Quiet.
You're not gonna happen. You can do it, but you're not gonna get your best result.
Absolutely.
That's my thing.
Absolutely.
You can do it, but I don't think that's the time that you're gonna get your best result. And so, like, football players should be going now.
Right.
This your time.
Right.
Knock it out,
Coach. Parents, they spend a lot of money on a lot of stuff that probably don't really mean nothing when it comes to this process. Do you recommend that they get a tutor or get with programs that have tutoring?
Oh, definitely. I think you should do that. Listen, the education part is the most important thing. So I would invest my money in the education part more so than anything.
But I got to have them J's, though, Coach.
No. You don't need no J's. If you need the J's, then okay, we'll pay for school. Make a choice.
Wendy, y'all been hanging out? He sounds just like you.
I'm just trying to tell you.
You got to make a choice. You know, it's a sacrifice that need to be made. And the sacrifice is, hey, I need some extra help with these core classes.
Right.
I'm having a problem with math, right, science, social studies,
ELA.
Foreign language, ELA. That's
it.
Language arts, English. You know, some of the parents didn't know what that was.
Yeah.
They know
so
that.
You have to invest in that, you know. And once you invest in that part, then all the other stuff. And like I say, that's an entitlement thing, like she was saying. That's an entitlement thing. If you think you have to get J's all the time, then you're not really serious about your craft in the first place.
You don't want
you
no
worry about the wrong thing.
You don't want no scholarship.
Yeah.
Stay focused, my friends.
Absolutely.
And there it is. Amen. Come back, we'll get some. You got some rundown for us?
Oh, man, I got plenty of rundown, man. We're going to laugh a little bit, too.
I love my rundown segment.
Let's get it.
Driving has a rhythm all its own. Don't wreck it with a text. Before you get behind the wheel, silence your phone. Or better yet, designate a texter. For more text-free driving tips, visit stoptextstoprex.org. Brought to you by the Ad Council and the National Highway Traffic Safety Administration.
When I grow up, I want to be a new pair of blue jeans.
When I grow up, I want to be a kid's first computer.
I want to be a warm place on a cold day.
I
want to
be a football stadium.
I want to be a bike that races around the country.
I want to be a bench on a forest trail.
When I grow up, I don't want to be a piece of garbage. And if you recycle me, I won't be.
Give your garbage another life. Recycle. Learn how at iwanttoberecycled.org.
Brought to you by Keep America Beautiful and the Ad Council.
Hi, this is Terry Crews, actor, former football player, and father of five. I'm also an expert on drama. There's the good kind that comes with having a house full of kids, and there's silly drama like the drama around my percolating pectorals. And then there's the drama you can skip.
Skip the drama that comes with not having your high school diploma or equivalency. Find free adult education classes near you and finish your diploma. Visit finishyourdiploma.org. That's finishyourdiploma.org.
And lead the drama to actors like me.
Brought to you by the Dollar General Literacy Foundation and the Ed Council.
This is Judge Hatchett, and you're listening to The Crush on SSNATL.com.
Hey, we're going to The Crush Rundown, brought to you by Parish Capital. At Parish Capital, we can help you achieve your financial goals by providing high-quality advisory services and making smart investment decisions. Go to parishcapital.com, P-A-R-R-S-H, capital with an A.com for more information. And shout-out to Kent Davis. He says something that you say every week, Wendy, get your fee waivers from your counselor.
Yeah, hit counselor, man. Coach Kent Davis.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. He was like, Coach Kent Davis, you better watch the wheel route.
Yeah,
all
you got to do is go over there and ask for him. That they send them to the schools to give to you all. They're not holding them hostage.
Hey, man, Coach Kent Davis susceptible to that wheel route, baby.
Call him out like that?
Yeah, that's my guy right there. Every coach can say, he's like, hey, man, you better watch that wheel route. He's going to throw that wheel out. Hey, man, a couple of stories for y'all, man. We're going to dive into, man. Two upcoming college freshmen, they're high school seniors right now, Jonathan Muhammad and Vashon Lamont St. Hill, were arrested after a fight during class. Both were charged with disorderly conduct. They could be expelled. They're putting their scholarship offers, one's going to South Carolina State, the other to Newberry College, in jeopardy.
What school they go to?
East Kids, South Carolina.
Oh, tell me if they was in, never mind, Fulton County.
We always talk about character, Coach. We always talk about character.
Ain't going to get in trouble here.
Oh, yeah, they facing expulsion.
Yeah. Yeah.
How could you throw your opportunity away?
On this
Undisciplined.
They're not focused.
Not focused.
It's not their priority.
Right, it's not a priority. Them Jordans and all that other stuff, I see.
Yep, it's not a priority.
The sad part is when you are kids like that, you have to be aware because there are going to be other kids who are going to hate, as they say.
Well, and this is what I always tell the kids at my school. I'm like, some of these kids have nothing to lose.
Exactly.
They may not graduate. They probably are not going to school. So if they come looking for a fight with you, it's in your best interest to turn and walk away from it. It may look like a punk move right now, but in the end, they have nothing to lose, so they don't care about getting in any trouble.
I ain't never seen nobody.
You have everything to lose right now.
I ain't never seen nobody 4 years later. Hey man, I ain't go to school because I wasn't a punk in the eighth. But
right.
I know you were stupid.
He ain't gonna punk me.
Right.
You were stupid.
That's all.
Whatever, man. Whatever. Next story. Michigan Wolverine tight end Devin Asiyi is transferring. Coach Harbaugh says the kid, he's in good academic standing, but you know, he was a four-star prospect. He's from California, got homesick, wants to be closer to home. And the crazy part about it, how it affects Michigan recruiting, they didn't sign a tight end this year.
Wow.
He was scheduled to replace the All-American Jake Butt.
Yep.
We talk about this all the time. When your mom and dad drop you off, are you going to be comfortable here? For 4 years.
Absolutely.
You better know.
You better know.
And especially with football, you ain't leaving for 3 years at the minimum. So you better find out if I can handle Michigan. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
It ain't like basketball. You can do a year maybe and get out.
The weather.
You better understand. This is a 3 year at least.
Yeah, there's a lot of factors that go into like if you're from the south and going up, even if you're from the north and coming down south,
right.
Like you may not be able to handle the heat. Like, you can't. Some people can't function down there in Albany without them nets and stuff. you know what I'm saying? There's some decisions got to be made around
right.
the thing.
I couldn't. Right. Even, I didn't. I, right.
They judge it off a weekend. I had fun.
Off that 48 hours.
Yeah.
Well, Harbaugh did well. If you saying that he did well for that weekend for you to be like that, boy, somebody need to say, boy, you know it's snow a lot.
It gets cold. It gets cold. It's not, like, just, really cold.
Yeah. Right. Coach, how much do you talk to your kids about when they making this decision? All of the factors that go into it.
We talk to them pretty often. I know I talk to my kids a lot about that. You be honest with them. Like, for instance, I got some of my children, you know, I'm talking about my kids personal. They can go certain places, and some of my kids, they ain't leaving Georgia.
Yeah.
Because of how the nest is.
Mm-hmm. Right.
So
and you got
to
know that.
You have to look at that, you know, and you have to be honest, man. You know, I as a kid, you know, how much you going to really miss your mom, man? Mm. Be honest with yourself. Mm. So you know you don't need to go to Nevada.
Right.
Because you're not going to be able to come home.
Absolutely.
Your mama can't drive out there to get you.
It's not going to work like that. And then, you know, the fact of it is you're not going to be able to pay a plane ticket just when you feel like you're ready to go. It doesn't work like that. So you gotta factor that in and just be honest with you. You got to look at what's the real reason you want to go out there. If it's just to be football, then I don't think that's the best idea. You better start looking at the demographic.
Right.
I want to get home. I want to visit. You know, I want to spend time with family. I want them to come see me play. You know, you got to look at all of that.
Yeah. All of that. Yeah. That's a factor.
Yeah.
Coach Ogden say three hots and a cot.
Oh, that's all we got at state.
Say Willie Jeffers. That one of the slogans.
I tell you, he gonna give you three hots and a cot and some free books. It's on you after that.
That's funny.
Hey, man. Our next story. Senior quarterback Montel Cozart. He's the third quarterback to transfer out of Kansas this offseason. Mm. Started 7 games last season. He's graduated, and word on the street, he is looking at HBCUs to play his last season of eligibility.
I don't understand. Bowl got jumping.
But I don't understand why these kids don't just start at an HBCU. Like, that's like, you're at Kansas. You probably 4th, 5th, 6th on the depth chart. It took him to his senior year to finally play. Dude, go and he started the first 7 games and got benched because they say he was ineffective. Mm-hmm. You probably would have been a gem in the SWAC, MEAC, or the SIAC, or the CIAA.
That's true.
For some reason, man, and we know the story of the kid here. It's when you say HBCU, it's like a wrong thing around here sometimes.
Like they frown up. Like,
but you know what I'm D1,
it just bothers me to see them when they go with that. And you know, you see kids saying, I want to go here. Why?
You know what I'm saying? For me it is, though. I keep telling y'all, they show up late.
There you go.
I keep telling y'all that.
They don't come.
And you know it.
Yeah. Oh, without a doubt.
They show up late.
And without a doubt.
So I think some of the kids genuinely may have considered those schools.
But they hadn't seen them.
But they hadn't seen them. And by the time they show up, they've started making commitments to those people that have already been coming, not even thinking that I may not play, but I need this scholarship if I'm going to school, because if I don't get this money, I'm not going.
And they also don't promote themselves very well. They don't.
This year, I was more involved than I've ever been. Like, I sat in when the coaches came into school, and I sat there and had the conversation with them and had answered some of those questions and gave them the materials. And when I tell you I didn't see any HBCUs to, like, the very end, I'm thinking, when y'all coming?
Right.
When are you going to do something about it? Can you call? Send a bird. I don't care. But like, you got to do something.
And we understand they don't, you know, the budget
is in there.
We understand that. But, yeah, you got to get out here.
Well,
you got to get out here.
But I understand the budgets, and that's true. But there's ways around that. Like, just for instance, they have like, coaching clinics, galas that you come to. And you can be in there with hundreds of coaches.
Right.
And they're not there.
Here's the thing, too. I would be more, why isn't schools that are within 100 miles hitting schools like Langton U?
Why Morehouse Club?
Why are not here in the streets? If I'm 100, if I know all this talent is out there?
Never.
Right.
I mean, we got two kids going to Morehouse, but, like, it was the end.
Yeah.
Yeah, everybody's saying that, but John Lewis said, kids need to think about it like it's a job, because when they come home, mom won't know if you're going to pay some bills. You're right, Jay.
You're right.
Yeah, man. Hey, man, we're about to take a quick break. Quick break. We'll be right back.
Uncle Dan?
Mom?
Dad?
If you store your guns properly, so not just anyone can get to them.
I'll feel safer when I'm playing outside.
Safer when walking home.
Safer when my friends come over.
As your neighbor, I'll feel safer.
As a school teacher, I'll feel safer.
We'll all feel safer.
Your family, friends, and neighbors are all counting on you.
If you own a gun, you have a full-time responsibility. When you aren't using it, be sure it can't get into the hands of curious children, troubled teenagers, a thief, or anyone else who might misuse it. Remember, always lock it up. For more information on firearm storage safety, visit ncpc.org. This message brought to you by the National Crime Prevention Council, the Bureau of Justice Assistance, and the Ad Council.
Well, you'll see what happens. Sensation Station Network.
This is Robert Hicks, ex-NFL football player and actor with The Blind Side, and you're with The Crush at SSNATL.com. Sensation Station.
I get my man later, man, but right now we're back in the second hour of the hottest recruiting show on. Make sure pissing people off a little bit with these recruits.
Whatever. Man. Whatever, man. I'm doing my job, man. Doing my job, man.
Hey, I'm going to the second hour, man. I get to people, man. I just got to pull it up. I ain't ready to say all that.
The pepper.
Oh,
yeah. We'll get to that. Hey, but we're still in our rundown right now.
Yes, sir.
And we'll get to that. And make sure, what else we got for us, man?
So, man, another homesick kid, Clemson defensive tackle Scott Pagano. He will transfer back to the West Coast to be closer to home. He's already graduated, so he will be eligible immediately to play. Won his national championship, so he Gucci.
Got a degree, got his ring.
I ain't going home to mama.
I'm stressed. Got 1 year eligibility. Hey, man, and he can land anywhere because he can play. I mean, he can play right away.
Wendy, what's the furthest one of your kids has went?
I got one at Fresno State.
When he was going, what were some of the conversations that were being had?
You know what? I don't think he's even homesick. Like, he does want to transfer, I think. He wants to come home, but I don't think it's because he's homesick. Okay. He's got some other stuff, you know, some other things he wants to come, you know, back this way for. Actually, I don't know that he necessarily even wants to come back this way. He wants to go somewhere else.
Okay. So it could be anywhere for him.
Yeah. I think he's probably the furthest one. But he, you know, we talked a long time about it. You know, I asked those questions. Are you ready to leave your mom? How often do you think they're going to be able to come see you? How often do you think you're coming home? You know, you're not coming home to Christmas, right?
Yeah, it's Christmas for real.
Right, and then maybe spring break. And then, you know, you might get one other time. That's going to be it because them tickets are expensive.
Right.
You know, so you try and have those conversations with them and you know, make sure. I mean, the good thing, like, we got FaceTime now. So, like, you know, we ain't had none of this stuff. So you really can see people and talk to them in real time right now.
Yeah.
So it's a little bit better, but, you know, you don't get that homecoming meal.
Instead of go to the mailbox, like, man, my man wrote me.
But you don't get that homecoming meal, you know, all those kind of things.
And cash is a little quicker now. Back then, you couldn't just drop in a little. You had to wait for and hope that check come through that mail.
Right. So, like, things are a little bit different now.
Yeah.
So, I think that those things make it easier. But, you know, some, like Coach Spoh said, some kids, you know, can't leave.
Yeah, but you ain't
around this, like,
but you ain't going outside 2 hours.
If it's more than 2 hours away, you know you're not going right. Mm-hmm. Because they got to be able to get there every Friday for the Saturday game. You know, it's all that stuff. You got to be able to come home.
Right.
So,
I just think it's interesting. Macy was talking about two transferring kids, and I'm like, this is something what y'all have to deal with. Like,
oh, yeah.
Hey, man, you know that's far, right? I mean, this is far. 3 days car.
Right.
4 hour plane.
Yeah, I'm telling them, like, the car, I'm telling them, how far do you know that's not a driving? They're not driving. You can't drive back and forth.
Mm-mm.
You know, and I'm telling them it's cold, it's hot.
Yeah.
You know, that's up in the mountains. You know, the air different. You like, you're trying to explain all these things because some of them haven't experienced all those. They might go and visit the campus, but they've never played in those type of conditions. And so it's very different because they're like, I'm like, y'all suited to move to here when it gets cold. Come November, December, when we outside. I don't know what you going to do on that sideline on Saturday. When it's 20 degrees or below.
They don't care. It's D1.
Yeah. Well.
I'm going.
Until they get there. And then they like, man, Miss Ghost, you know how cold it was at the game?
Yeah.
All I can say is,
hey, man, in our privilege story right here, and this, we talk about this all the time, Kurt Warner, the Hall of Fame quarterback, his son is walking on at Nebraska as a wide receiver. He only had one scholarship offer, and that was to FCS, University of San Diego. But his dad got the money to send him wherever he want to go.
So he can walk on. He
can walk on anywhere. And, Coach, I always tell people this all the time. Hey, you think your son that good, you can gamble on his talent. Hey, pay for him to go to this. Listen, if y'all want to go to Georgia and Florida and the U, pay for it.
They will take your money. Let me tell you something. They will take your money.
Pay for it.
They will take your money.
They might not
touch
the field, but go on and pay for it.
Yeah.
But you got offers on the table. Go on and pay for it.
Go on and pay for it.
That's basically like saying, well, I'm going to take their money.
Because we got to go and pay for the commercial, man. We'll be right back.
Coming to Tampa Bay, I said we want to win a Super Bowl, and I believe we will.
From IamSecond.com.
We came close, but never really did win that championship.
Former NFL head coach Tony Dungy.
At the end of my sixth year, I was fired, and it was one of the biggest disappointments of my life. Next year, I'm in Indianapolis, get to the playoffs, but get knocked out again. And for the next couple of years, it's the same thing. Everyone is saying Colts are never going to win one. And I did wonder, why didn't it pan out the way I thought it would? But I determined that I had to have Christ first, and that everything else came below that, including my own desires. The next year, that ended up being our year to go to the Super Bowl and win it. And it was a wonderful feeling. Every decision I make, I'm going to make it through the lens of Jesus Christ, and he'd guide us to that ultimate victory. I'm Tony Dungy, and I am Second.
Okay, so five tacos of cheese and a large soda, that's $10,012. Please drive around.
Wait, 10,000 what?
It's obvious you're buzzed and driving.
I've only had a few. I'm fine.
Yeah, the food's $12, but getting pulled over for buzz driving could cost you around $10,000 in fines, legal fees, and increased insurance rates. Please drive around. Actually, just park and come in.
Nothing kills a buzz like getting pulled over for buzz driving, because buzz driving is drunk driving. Brought to you by the National Highway Traffic Safety Administration and the Ad Council.
Listen, as a hiring manager, I've got to tell you, the best job candidate isn't always the typical candidate. Sometimes they're a grad of life.
Meet the grads of life. Young adults of unique determination and experience. An ideal fit for your company in an entry-level position, internship, or mentorship. They might not have every qualification you typically look for, but they're exactly who your company needs.
Sometimes the best candidates aren't the ones you're used to.
Go to gradsoflife.org to learn how to find, cultivate, and train this great pool of untapped talent. Brought to you by the Ad Council and gradsoflife.org.
Vince Lombardi once said that it's hard to be aggressive when you're confused. Some of us think that taking our lives to the next level, both personally and professionally, is a confusing and complicated process. Guess what? It's not, and I can prove it. My book, Truisms, will show you how living your life by rules that are so self-evident and obvious, you'll say, I knew that. This powerful yet short, detailed bestseller is on sale right now, under $10. Go to michaelmcfadden.com. That's michaelmcfadden.com, and let Truisms help you to the next level.
George,
y'all need anything
else?
Sensation Station Network.
This is Keon Carpenter, former Atlanta Falcon. You are tuned in to The Crush on Sensation Station Network.
Hey, man. She got the keys. She got this knowledge, too. Wendy, you ready to drop a little wisdom on everybody?
I am ready.
Go ahead, knock it out.
Let's get it.
So last week, I talked about the parents. But you know what? I feel this week is a good time. It's off season for football. Basketball is about to end, to talk about what the role of the student athlete is in this process.
What students need to be doing, Wendy?
So, you know, I think, you know, are you on a student study hall? Are you going to tutorial sessions? These are the things you need to be asking yourself, because this is the time you're doing it. You know, what's your character like? What are you doing every day? What are you doing when no one else is looking? Are you hardworking in the classroom and on the field? What are you doing for your off season? How are you as a teammate? Because it's not all about you.
People want to know.
Yeah, they want to know this. Are you attending all of your out-of-season workouts? Are you committed 100%? You 90%? You 50%? You know, we got some that's 0%, too. They just want to show up for games.
Oh, yeah. I'm a spat up, though.
Look.
Wendy, I always laugh at Macy. I'm talking about their off-season.
But there is no off-season. You know I believe in that, though.
Hey, man, you better go on somewhere.
I was a captain. Of debauchery. Keep it moving.
You know, are you going to work on skills that you need to improve? Have you talked to your coach so you can find out what you need to be working on so you can improve on those things, so that if you maybe weren't first string last year, you can be this year? Think about what your teachers would tell a college recruiter. So when you in class and you spending time with these teachers, what would, if you had to ask them to write a recommendation, what would they say about you? Teachers are human too, and I think that's the thing, something that a lot of kids forget. You know, when you don't show up to our class on time, and when you don't give, you know, 100% in our class, when you on that borderline, we think about all them times you didn't give what you needed in our particular class. You know, how self-motivated are you? And remember that your first impression is a lasting impression. So let's talk about your handshake. I met this kid today. His handshake was so serious, it almost shocked me.
Yeah.
I was like,
he been practicing.
He eye contact and everything. Somebody told him.
He's been working on it.
So a firm handshake. Don't come up with these weak handshakes. I'm like, dude.
Hand down.
What is that?
Hand down. Twisting your hair.
Right.
Holding your pants up.
One hand on your pants and one hand out, dude. Don't come anywhere by me doing that.
If your wrist broke, don't do it.
Don't do it. You know, making sure you're saying yes and no and like yeah, nah, and huh, and
nah,
don't
man.
Do that. You know, be yourself, though, and still show your personality.
Yeah.
Because I think that's what's important, because they want to see the person that you are. Give praise to your teammates and coaches. That's big. You know, y'all need to start doing this on your Twitters and stuff. Talk about your teammates and stuff. That shows what kind of person you are.
Not all the time blessed to get my 30th offer.
Right.
Right.
I'm blessed to get my 50th offer.
Your offer.
Sit down somewhere, man.
And then also, you know what goals you have in place. Because, you know, this is my favorite part, my most important part. Let's talk about these A's and these B's.
Mm-hmm.
I keep telling y'all, for this class, 2017 is gone. Let's talk about the class 2018. That GPA requirement is going up for D2 schools. You're going to have a 2.2 to hit the field. And if you don't have it, what are your plans?
Now, it ain't no excuse for you.
Now, we saying HBCU's coming late, and then you ain't got the GPA, so something ain't adding up.
Man, you should have a 2.0 in your sleep.
Right.
You should at least have a 2.5 in your sleep. I'm just saying, man, like, if you just, I just don't understand it.
And honestly, at my school, I expect the athletes to be the example.
I expect
for them to be, is that you need to be in the front of the class. If something's going wrong, if another kid is acting up, I actually expect for you to be like, Ben, chill.
Yeah.
I do.
Yeah.
Because a lot of kids respect you and what you do. And if you speak up, then now others will too. And that'll keep those, you know, two or three that want to act out, they'll pull them in the line too.
I've always said that football season and the athletes set the tone for the school year.
Definitely.
Yeah.
Definitely.
It seemed like, and it probably every case, because like you said, a good football season, basketball team playing well.
Yep.
Hateville Charter, y'all had a good football season. Basketball team still rolling. You set the tone. If the football team serve, they're gonna sit out the whole school year.
That's the first thing. That's the first thing.
Oh, y'all sorry too. Oh, you play for them? Oh, y'all sorry.
And lastly want to say for today is, you know, it's about your effort and your attitude.
Can't coach that.
Effort and attitude.
Two things you can't
keep
coach.
Them together, people. Keep them together. And parents, encourage your kids to do it. Encourage them to do the right thing.
You know what's funny, man? One of the things, and Wendy was talking about,
yeah.
One of the things I wish kids really would understand, if I had a bad year and I'm still playing, this is my time to get it back, to work on my skills, man. You know what I'm saying? Coach said my back pedal was terrible. Guess what I'm working on, Mason?
Working
on the back pedal.
Right. But you can't work on your back pedal hanging out on the stoop over there with that girl.
Exactly.
To see your health.
And find,
right.
And Coach said it earlier, find a homeboy that working.
Yeah, that's the group you need to be. You need to be with the homeboy that working.
Right.
If you hanging out with the class cutters and the guys at the end of the bench, that's where you going to be. Right.
That's where you going to play.
Yeah.
I've never understood, like, dude, why you running with them?
Yeah.
Right. Surround yourself with people who can elevate you.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Iron sharpen eyes, people.
Man,
you do.
And Jello molds into other Jello.
I'm telling you, man. If he missing practice, chances are eventually you gonna miss practice too.
Right.
Yeah.
As opposed to let me get with the guy who playing, who name in the paper. I'm gonna hang around them every day.
I used to always get.
That's
tell.
The one I'm going to work out with.
Exactly. Yeah. You could always tell. You say who he hang out with. That's his crew.
That's a sign of a true competitor.
Yeah.
Right.
That's so you're a real competitor. The first thing you do, and I'm gonna outwork you.
Right. I'm trying. I'm everything.
Everything you do, and I'm gonna do better.
Yeah.
That's a true competitor.
It seems like now that the competition is like, how can I get out of doing something?
Absolutely.
Oh, my God.
That's the big competition. How can I get out of going to workouts? God. You know, I'm telling people, I say, you're supposed to be the leader.
Listen, me and Mel had to sit next to our English teacher. She had to put, I sat on one side, Mel sat on the other side. But, dude, I got 90.
Yeah.
I got 95. Oh, okay, well, there we go. I got 100. I got 100, too.
Yeah.
I can bitch more than you. No, you can't. That's what you're supposed to do.
I went to see flags after. Hey, man, we'll be right.
Marie Callender's knows that you may not have time to roll out dough for a perfectly flaky crust that's made from scratch. Or enough time to mix vegetables with all white meat chicken and a homemade gravy. She knows you may not have a moment to crimp the edges of your favorite chicken pot pie. But Marie Callender's does. And when she's done, all you need to do is find time to grab someone special. Sit down and savor. Marie Callender's, it's time to savor.
Vince Lombardi once said that it's hard to be aggressive when you're confused. Some of us think that taking our lives to the next level, both personally and professionally, is a confusing and complicated process. Guess what? It's not, and I can prove it. My book, Truisms, will show you how living your life by rules that are so self-evident and obvious, you'll say, I knew that. This powerful yet short, detailed bestseller is on sale right now, under $10. Go to michaelmcfadden.com. That's michaelmcfadden.com, and let Truisms help you to the next level.
Okay, so 5 tacos of cheese and a large soda, that's $10,012. Please drive around.
Wait, 10,000 what?
It's obvious you're buzzed and driving.
I've only had a few. I'm fine.
Yeah, the food's $12, but getting pulled over for buzz driving could cost you around $10,000 in fines, legal fees, and increased insurance rates. Please drive around. Actually, just park and come in.
Nothing kills a buzz like getting pulled over for buzz driving, because buzz driving is drunk driving. Brought to you by the National Highway Traffic Safety Administration and the Ad Council.
When I grow up, I want to be a new pair of blue jeans.
When I grow up, I want to be a kid's first computer.
I want to be a warm place on a cold
day. I want to be a football stadium.
I want to be a bike that races around the country.
I want to be a bench on a forest trail.
When I grow up, I don't want to be a piece of garbage. And if you recycle me, I won't be.
Give your garbage another life. Recycle. Learn how at iwanttoberecycled.org. Brought to you by Keep America Beautiful and the Ad Council.
Hey, what's up? It's your boy, Killer Mike, Killer Kia from the Ville. You're checking me out right now on the Sensation Station Network. Make sure you tune in, suckers.
Hey, man, we're back. Give a shout out to Doug Pepper Painting and Pressure Washing with over 30 years of experience. The smart people call on Doug Pepper Painting and Pressure Washing. I put that puh in the interior, exterior, commercial, or residential. Doug Pepper does it all. If your house is looking ugly, call on Doug. Doug Pepper Painting and Pressure Washing, 404-966-3361. Mention WBLZ Sports, and you will receive a special We Got Balls discount. That's Doug Pepper Painting and Pressure Washing, 404-966-3361. Shout out to our man, Coach White, man. He gave us a quick three. Maceo, he said, ask for extra help. Mm-hmm. Do all of your work. And third, shut the hell up. Coach White.
That should be number one for me. I say that all the time.
Just check the hell up, y'all. What you got for a dog?
Hey, man. So, our recruiting roundtable subject tonight. A couple of SEC coaches got together, Bielema and a couple other guys. And this has been coming to light a lot lately. Recruiting services. What are their real value? And one of the things that, since we've been doing this, we've been getting a lot of emails, a lot of phone calls, and people are not understanding what a recruiting service do. They just don't get it. Coach Pope, what are your thoughts on recruiting services?
That's why you laughing.
Recruiting services are a joke.
Oh, okay.
For real.
Mm.
An absolute joke. Listen, you pay somebody to contact coaches, and you give them money, and they tell you anything you want to hear, and that's not true. All you have to do is sit down with your coach at the high school and ask him, listen, what scouts are coming in here, who have you contacted, and he's supposed to, basically, most coaches are supposed to say, look, we contacted this guy, he has this type of interest, or they have no interest or whatever. If they have true interest, this is his number, So you can contact him and set up visits. They want you to come on a visit, stuff like that. You don't really need a recruiting service. What you need to do is have a better relationship with your high school coaches. Mm. Bottom line.
Now, a lot of people would like to say, well, high school coaches, they don't do this. They don't reach out and do that. I'm always under the mind of, you know, you are who recruits you. Mm-hmm. You know, because a high school coach, as a high school coach, I can only give out your huddle. I can only give out your transcript. If it was up to us, every kid would get a scholarship.
Right, because that makes us look good.
But that's not how these guys get paid, the college coaches. So the thing, and one of the things Brett Bielema kept saying was, like, I'm going to listen to a high school coach before I listen to somebody who was hired by a parent to try to sell said kid.
Absolutely, because the coach is the one coaching his kid every day. He's watched him walk the halls. He's watching how he speaks to the teachers, how he his character. He's there every day. He's with your kid just as much as you are, basically.
Yeah.
So he knows the ins and outs and the things that, you know, he needs to work on, what he does on the field, you know, all of that. So that's why I say it's important for you to develop a relationship with your high school coaches and then, you know, start working towards that goal with them and the scouts that you're dealing with in the college ranks. That's how you do it. Recruiters, what can a recruiter say? All he can do is basically put your huddle up the same way we do and say, this kid is a heck of a player. He weighs this amount, and this is what he can do. But he can't get you the intricate. What's his home life about? What, you know, what's going on in his home?
What happens at school?
What type of student is he? Mm. You know, is he a leader?
Because if I'm a coach at a college level, I'm going to be with somebody who's with the kid 5 days a week.
Absolutely.
Who sees how he does in the classroom. Mm-hmm. And all of that. Because it's at the end of the day, Mason, we always say, whose work is it? It's the kid's work.
Right.
And you, and then the people that know you or your parents who with you every day and the coach who coach you every day. If somebody else is taking that stuff and giving it to him, and that's why Bill would say, I'm going to listen to this first one. Now, if the coach, I'm going to listen to this guy here.
I've been with him. You've been with him every day.
Yeah.
All summer.
Yeah.
You took him here. You did this. You did that. Wendy, go ahead. Go ahead, because you got a lot on this. You got a lot to say.
That's why
on
I got
this.
Mine in first and then step back. Like,
yeah, because Wendy is fire hot about this thing right here.
Yeah, so, because I have to deal with it.
Right.
I deal with it on the end that I don't feel like the coaches are doing enough for me, but then I also do it on the end that I pay someone, and I don't feel like I'm getting what I need to be getting from that person either. And when I ask them, well, what are they doing? It's the same thing that we were doing. Mm. You know, when a coach comes in, we show a little bit of huddle from everybody that we have that's coming out that year. We don't go and pick and choose, or we say, Coach, what are you looking for? And then we start saying we have this many people in this position. Mm-hmm. And we show everybody. And this is my thing. There is nothing that I think a recruiter can do for you that you can't do. Like, all this information is out here and it's free.
Mm.
You can get out here. You can read. You can ask coaches. You can go to any. You can ask any coach. Like, I don't think any coach wants to withhold information from a parent about the process.
I mean, I don't think so.
Wants to withhold information.
Yeah. Yeah.
You know, and so even if you can't talk to your coach, you have your kid knows another coach somewhere else that they can just ask a question or two to, or that you have a relationship that you can ask a question or two to. So, I mean, like, I had a 10th grader come to me yesterday, and he said, Ms. Gosson, I want to start sending emails out. I said, all right. I said, well, let's work you up a draft. Let's talk about it. Let's work you up a draft. And then this is the kind of personal information you're going to have to put in here on each mail, because you can't send it out as a mass email because they're going to realize it's a mass email when
mm-hmm.
they get it.
Mm-hmm.
And so I told him he needs to talk about the school and what the school means to him and not just about, you know, hey, this is me. Here's my huddle.
Yeah.
Your huddle out there for free anyway. They're going to find y'all anyway. So I just think I ain't paying one.
Let me ask you this, Coach.
I ain't going to pay one.
I ain't going to let them all do it. What's your thoughts?
We just getting into this. We gonna delve into it.
Yeah. But what I want to ask her real quick before I give my thought.
Okay.
I feel like parents have to play such an important role in this recruiting process, and I think the parent. I've always said the parents don't do enough.
No, they don't.
They don't do enough.
They don't. But to some degree, the parents don't want to. You the coach. You supposed to do everything. You know what I mean? And I'm not trying to be funny, but you basically have to force your parents to be in a way where, hey, such and such came to the school today, he got a lot of interest, or he made an offer to your son. This is what you need to do. I need you to contact him tonight. He said to contact him tonight, do this. You forced him to get involved.
All right, Coach, man, we're going to be right back. Stay with us, guys. We just started.
So I'm a dog, and I just got adopted by this new human guy, and I'm starting to wonder how he got along without me. I mean, okay, something as simple as walking around the block. He's got this leash thing, and he puts me on one end and him on the other, and I'm just taking him around. I think he's afraid of getting lost. Without that leash and me guiding him along, I don't think he'd find his way back home. But it's kind of cute.
A person is the best thing to happen to a shelter pet. Be that person. Adopt. Brought to you by the Ad Council and the ShelterPetProject.org.
Coming to Tampa Bay, I said we want to win a Super Bowl, and I believe we will.
From IamSecond.com.
We came close, but never really did win that championship.
Former NFL head coach Tony Dungy.
At the end of my sixth year, I was fired, and it was one of the biggest disappointments of my life. Next year, I'm in Indianapolis, get to the playoffs, but get knocked out again. And for the next couple of years, it's the same thing. Everyone is saying Colts are never going to win one. And I did wonder, why didn't it pan out the way I thought it would? But I determined that I had to have Christ first, and that everything else came below that, including my own desires. The next year, that ended up being our year to go to the Super Bowl and win it. And it was a wonderful feeling. Every decision I make, I'm going to make it through the lens of Jesus Christ. And he'd guide us to that ultimate victory. I'm Tony Dungy, and I am Second.
Listen, as a hiring manager, I've got to tell you, the best job candidate isn't always the typical candidate. Sometimes they're a grad of life.
Meet the grads of life. Young adults of unique determination and experience. An ideal fit for your company in an entry-level position, internship, or mentorship. They might not have every qualification you typically look for, but they're exactly who your company needs.
Sometimes the best candidates aren't the ones you're used to.
Go to gradsoflife.org to learn how to find, cultivate, and train this great pool of untapped talent. Brought to you by the Ad Council and gradsoflife.org.
If you're looking for that ratchet, you're in the wrong place. It's the nation's urban internet station, Sensation Station Network.
This is University of Georgia linebacker Demetrius Douglas. You're tuned in to The Crush on Sensation Station Network.
Hey, man. Cole White say recruit services do one thing.
Take money.
Nothing.
Take, get rich.
You're right, nothing.
All right, man. We still on this, man, and it was brought up, and I'm glad we talking about it. If you didn't see, Bielema and with Penn State coach.
James Franklin
talked about this and all that, so that's why we bringing it to the forefront. Macy, what else you got, man, on this?
Well, I mean, this is the thing. And I have to ask him all the time, I mean, what are you doing?
Yeah.
And when you tell me what you're doing, it's no different than what the high school coaches are doing. So when you tell me that you can contact this person, okay, well, contact them. And I know you can't. Because, like, say, we've all coached long enough. We have relationships with these guys. Like, say, we can pick up the phone. Like, say, Brian McClendon sitting in that chair.
Like, no, this is the thing. I'm not a coach. And they call me.
That's what.
I'm getting text messages this past weekend. Can you send this? I'm like, I'm off work.
Right.
I'm not the coach.
So, right. And so my thing is, and what's happening, so when a parent who has hired you calls me, mm-hmm. I'm like, well, what's wrong with your recruiting service? Well, I can't get them on the phone.
Oh, okay.
Why I can't get you on the phone and I've paid you X amount of dollars? Now, that don't make no sense. Now, that's going to lead to somebody, you know, no offense, you get seen about in these streets.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Folks get real about their money now.
Absolutely. Because, I mean, I'm, and this is the thing, you can't see,
You can't make a promise to a parent and a kid, especially when that kid is not being recruited by those schools. You can't go, I don't care who you are, I can't call B-Mac and tell B-Mac, hey, I got
this kid.
I got this dude 5'7", 135, but he can play wide out for you. B-Mac gonna look at me like,
what's calling me for?
Yeah, bruh.
Really?
Bro, matter of fact, lose my number now.
Right.
Like, we done fell out now.
Your credibility is now gone.
It's gone.
Yeah.
So, these recruiting services, and I'm sitting there like, really, I mean, what are you doing? So, like I say, I done gave you $1,000, $1,500.
$3,000.
Dude, you better answer my phone call.
Every time I call.
But when they answer, if they do answer the call, what are they going to tell you? What are they going to tell you? They're going to say, I contacted some people, and they give you a list of these things, people that they talk to. But then the problem is you never get to encounter any of these coaches. You don't talk to them.
You don't know if it ever happened.
Yeah, you don't know. You know what I'm saying? So
it's too many unknowns.
Absolutely.
It's too many unknowns.
I wouldn't even take the risk. I wouldn't take the risk. When you can do the same thing, you can do it. You can do it. Parents can do it themselves. Parents, you can do the same thing. You can go online. If your son is interested in 10 schools, go online and look at the school. Okay, they have the coach's office number. They have the coach's email right there.
Yeah.
You know, you can do that yourself. You can send out your huddle yourself if you just don't trust what the coach is doing.
And then this is the thing, too. Like, coaches, I will say this. They say they get a lot of email. We talked to B-Man. B-Man talked about this. He gets a lot of email. And he said some of them he just doesn't get to open it because he realizes what they are. If you talk to your coach and tell your coach, hey, coach, send my information to them. Because a lot of times they know the coaches. They know our names.
Yeah.
And so if it comes from me, they may open it. Now, that still may not get you any further.
Yeah.
Because you still may not be the guy that they're looking for. You may not have passed their eye test. But at least they may open the email if it's coming from a coach at your school. And that's why I always send stuff out for kids from my full, you know, from the school email address. Mm-hmm. Because they're going to see that it comes from a school email address. And it's not coming from my Gmail.
Right. And again, that's what just the funny part is, like, schools are hiring staffs just to look at highlights.
Yes.
Look at that, and those highlights move to this room.
Right.
Move to this room,
and then, get on
and then they start weeding out.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Then they on the board.
But your huddle can make it to some film. To some, somebody's gonna see it.
Definitely.
But it's their decision. Like, you can give me $10,000 right now. I still can't get you in Georgia.
Yeah.
With everybody I know down there, I still can't get you in if you're not what they're looking for.
But it still goes back to the coaches. The real format of it is they come to the school, you sit down with the coach, they watch the film, then they'll say, well, you know, if it's, you know, at that time of the season where they can't take a look at the kid, they want to see if this kid really is 6'4", 255 pounds. If he, in his film, they write that down and say, give me all this information. He gets in a database that they go back and they have meetings where the whole staff sit there and evaluate your film.
Right.
So when they evaluate their film, they come back and say, hey, we want to offer this kid. It may not be your kid. It may be a kid now in Las Vegas. You know, but that's what they do.
But unfortunately,
and, you know,
man.
The thing is, I was going to say real quick, Glaze, football is one of the sports that is still recruited through high school.
Absolutely.
A lot of the other stuff has moved out to, it's one of the last, the last
and
yeah. Yeah, because really, like, a lot, like we said, basketball has really moved to AAU, mm-hmm. You know.
Baseball is
baseball is your traveling team.
Yeah, yeah.
Soccer is club.
Yeah.
Swimming is through your club. So many things are outside of the school, but football is one of those things that is still really recruited through school, because nobody plays rec after a certain point, really. Yeah, you know what I'm saying? So the thing is, they coming in that school building. They checking for them there.
Hey, man, we got to take a break on that note right there. We'll be right back.
So I'm a dog, and I just got adopted by this new human guy, and I'm starting to wonder how he got along without me. I mean, okay, something as simple as walking around the block. He's got this leash thing, and he puts me on one end and him on the other, and I'm just taking him around. I think he's afraid of getting lost. Without that leash and me guiding him along, I don't think he'd find his way back home. But it's kind of cute.
A person is the best thing to happen to a shelter pet. Be that person. Adopt. Brought to you by the Ad Council and the ShelterPetProject.org.
Adopt US Kids presents Multiple Choice Parenting.
You've accidentally cut your daughter's bangs unevenly. Do you A, line things up a centimeter from her hairline?
Man, oh man, oh man, oh man, oh man!
No, sweatbands are so hot right now. Everyone's wearing them, like that basketball player and that other basketball player.
B, get spiritual.
Mom, where did all the mirrors go?
A reflection could never capture our true selves.
Huh?
Beauty is within?
C, look on the bright side.
Less time blow drying, more time texting.
Or D, show empathy.
Mom, you really don't have
to... Ta-da! Twinsies!
I kinda love it.
As a parent, there are no perfect answers. But you don't have to be perfect to be a perfect parent. Thousands of teens in foster care will love you just the same.
For more information on how you can adopt, visit AdoptUSKids.org. A public service announcement from the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services, Adopt U.S. Kids, and the Ad Council.
Driving has a rhythm all its own. Don't wreck it with a text. Before you get behind the wheel, silence your phone. Or better yet, designate a texter. For more text-free driving tips, visit stoptextstoprex.org. Brought to you by the Ad Council and the National Highway Traffic Safety Administration.
Hey, this is Teddy Parrish, and you're listening to The Crush on SSNATL.com.
Hey, man. I feel like some of you parents need to do this, but you know what hits me with this, Maceo, the most? It sounds like a lot of lazy parents that just say, why would I want to do all that, give you some $100, and let's roll the dice and see what happens. You know what I'm saying?
I keep trying to tell you, that's why I'm going to continue to say parents have to be all into this process.
Yeah.
Staffs have to have, you have to have that parent meeting.
You got to.
You got to have, in the spring, you got to have another meeting. If you got to bring people in to talk to the parents, they have to hear this information because, again, when your clock start in the ninth grade, if you say you want to play college sport, any sport, you got to find out what needs to be done, who I need to contact to get my child in position to get a free ride.
Real quick, shout out to two people right here. Catrice Carter Martinez says, more kids need to hear this, what we're talking about.
She was by my school today. Hey.
And Coach White would like parents. Just what you just said. Build a relationship with your high school coach. Your coach should know who you are.
This is the thing. It benefits the coach the more kids he's able to put into these schools,
absolutely,
into these programs. So that's why I always say when parents are like, well, they not doing enough for my kid. Why wouldn't they?
Yeah.
Like, why wouldn't they? Because that makes the coach look good, because he has more kids signing and more kids being able to go on and play at the next level. So why wouldn't I try and help a kid?
Because it looks more impressive to have 12 kids signing on signing day than two.
I'm just saying.
Right.
It looks real good.
Yeah, it's like.
I'm just saying.
You know what I'm saying?
That's what I'm telling myself. Like, why wouldn't he give them the information?
Yeah.
Because it was very impressive that you guys signed today to see the number of kids up there and to have all of the students to come watch there.
Yeah.
Right.
I mean, that's magical.
That's a process.
Right there. Yeah. I mean, you know, to see the parents dressed in the different school colors and the paraphernalia. I'm like, y'all had hats from every school.
Oh, yeah.
Mm-hmm. From every school.
Mm-hmm. You better believe them schools, Lord, to send them hats too, don't they?
Oh, definitely. definitely, man. But it helps you grow your program, because it helps you grow your program, and it, the younger kids, now they got aspirations to do something. Because they were like, Coach, next year when I get up there, I'm going to do this.
Right.
You know what I mean? Coach, wait till I get
something
up there.
For them to look forward to.
Yeah.
Does this bother you the way it bothered me, Coach? You have kids. They see what's going on with the class in front of them. They see what's going on. And the next year, they make the same mistakes.
That's the hardest part of this whole process.
Is
they'll see a kid in a situation, but I don't know what's going on in these kids' psyche nowadays. They think that it's not gonna happen to me.
Right.
And I'm like, dude, you struggling right now. All you have to do is this. But my whole situation with that is, again, the parents are not pushing it.
Yeah.
See, we're pushing it, but we don't have that reinforcement. You know, and when you start seeing the difference between this kid going somewhere, start looking at sometimes the parent or the humbleness of the kid to do what you need him to do. Right. There's two factors. Either the kid going to be extremely disciplined and do what you ask him to do, or he's going to be that type of kid that needs that structure, need to be pushed, but that parent always saying, coach, what do you need me to do? Okay, I make sure I got that taken care of too. Right. I do it on my side.
And Wendy says this all the time. Every kid recruiting process is different.
Oh yeah.
Everybody, you can't look at what he doing and think your story's gonna be like, y'all two different kids.
Absolutely.
Two different attitudes. Two different athletes.
Shouldn't even want your story to be like somebody else. That's my thing. Why do you want to be like somebody? Hey, why fit in when you were born to stand out?
Yep.
Boy. And trust me,
one of my favorites.
I tell everybody, I was a negative two star. I ain't get a chance to do it. My boy went up to 7 deep, and I was like, that's all right. I got an academic scholarship. I ain't worried about that. But still, it was just, and each one of them said it was just fun to do their process, and that's why don't worry about what he did.
Yeah.
You get to go to your own college visits. You get to do all your own. You sign your own paper.
Yeah.
You and your homeboy ain't going to be on the LOI. It's just his name, his mom and dad's name, and they're moving on to the next kid.
You signing your own paper, man. So it's your journey.
Which brings me to this, Coach. I want to talk about this, too. On-campus camps versus the one-day camps, where it's no college guys here, but getting your kid evaluated on a college campus. How important are those college camps?
That's the most important thing, because they're the ones that's going to evaluate you. They're the coaches that are looking for you. That other stuff, the kids like gear. They like Under Armour.
Shiny things.
It's free stuff. And I ain't mad at that. But the problem is, then you don't take the real stuff serious. If I can get in front of Nick Saban, just like, what's the kid that's with the Raiders now? He had no offers.
Yeah.
The receiver.
Yeah.
He had no offers. His coach drove him all the way from Miami to Alabama, and he showed himself in the camp. But see, a lot of problem right now is a lot of these kids that's got the 4-5 stars, when you show up to those real camps, you get exposed and you may have a possibility of losing it. So you don't want to go. But you'd rather do these little camps where you know those beat writers again, hey, that's my guy. I'm writing about him. He always called me and contacted me. I'm gonna push him.
We're about to take this quick break real quick because you don't want that type of exposure. But we'll be right back.
That you may not have time to roll out dough for a perfectly flaky crust that's made from scratch. Or enough time to mix vegetables with all white meat chicken and a homemade gravy. She knows you may not have a moment to crimp the edges of your favorite chicken pot pie. But Marie Callender's does. And when she's done, all you need to do is find time to grab someone special. Sit down and savor. Marie Callender's, it's time to savor.
Driving has a rhythm all its own. Don't wreck it with a text. Before you get behind the wheel, silence your phone. Or better yet, designate a texter. For more text-free driving tips, visit stoptextstoprex.org. Brought to you by the Ad Council and the National Highway Traffic Safety Administration.
Uncle Dan?
Mom?
Dad?
If you store your guns properly, so not just anyone can get to them.
I'll feel safer when I'm playing outside.
Safer when walking home.
Safer when my friends come over.
As your neighbor, I'll feel safer.
As a school teacher, I'll feel safer.
We'll all feel safer.
Your family, friends, and neighbors are all counting on you. If you own a gun, you have a full-time responsibility. When you aren't using it, be sure it can't get into the hands of curious children, troubled teenagers, a thief, or anyone else who might misuse it. Remember, always lock it up. For more information on firearm storage safety, visit ncpc.org. This message brought to you by the National Crime Prevention Council, the Bureau of Justice Assistance, and the Ad Council.
JBT 700 Miami Circle 30324. It's not a chain, it's a chain reaction.
Invest $49 a month at a real gym.
For more info, go to facebook.com/
Jeans Body Tech.
What's up? It's Garrison Hurst, University of Georgia. You're listening to The Crush on Sensation Station Network. Go Dawgs.
Easy. I'm sorry. Jeezy. He got me looking over here and make sure how many brown eyes been to the league, man. Over a dozen.
Yeah, man.
Yeah,
man.
I'm happy over it.
I mean, hey, can't be down forever. Yeah. Every now and then, you're going to get a shot.
Yeah, man. Hey, keep it going, man. What you got for it, man?
So, just kind of staying with these rules of recruiting, almost, man. That's kind of what this done turned into today, man. We kind of just echoing what we've always talked about with this recruiting process. And I kind of put something out today where we're saying build relationships with programs showing you the most interest. To me, this has always been important simply because we're not chasing nobody.
Right.
These are the schools. This school say that you probably the best recruit that they've ever had. Mm-hmm. Man, I'm talking to them. A lot.
Right.
Versus, can we see what Auburn talking about? Mm-hmm. We can, but, do they even know you alive?
Right.
I just think kids, they miss money. They miss the boat when we out here chasing, when you actually do have offers on the table.
Right. Right. But, it's a fad thing, because, like you say, a lot of kids get on here and say they blessed it. Get an offer from Georgia, and then when the Georgia scout come in and say, "Well, I didn't offer that kid," but now that's what they thinking that it has to be done. Everybody's the follow the leader type.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? That. So my whole thing is now, man, you just have to, like you say, love the schools that love you. You should be blessed. You should be happy the fact that any college scout were willing to come in and say,
any college
we
scout
want you to come play for us. We're willing to pay for your education and allow you to play football. I don't care where the school is. When they come in and say that, you need to take heed of that and say, listen, show me around. Let me get an opportunity.
Right. Because it's going to be more kids not doing the hats and, mm-hmm. and taking off the, those are I call them the blessed elite kids.
Absolutely.
That's 1%. Everybody not going to go through that.
Do me a favor. How many kids you said went to Clemson that played this year that weren't in those – 5 stars and all that stuff.
Oh, 10 out of 11.
It's just opportunity is going to come if you go out there and do what you got to do, man.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? It's funny that we say the same thing over and over again. That's why we keep driving into this. Just do what you got to do. And if it isn't at the level, there are, I got to find a number. There's some HBCU kids that are going to be in the combine this week.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
There's some D2 kids that's going to be with that.
Kid from West Georgia got invited to the combine.
Combine.
Yeah.
Because they putting in the work when they get there.
And this kid is I got Purdue.
Yeah.
He didn't get invited to the combine.
Yeah. Mm. He's 6'4". You know what I'm saying? But it just
played in the East-West Shrine game.
Yeah.
Didn't get an invite to the combine.
Wow.
So we're not even talking about the next level. It's like when you get the opportunity to play the game.
You just want to play.
Just if you really that good, they will trust me. You think they find you at the high school level? They really find you at the other level, man. You know what I'm saying?
Definitely.
So if you get it, man, listen to your coach and don't be unhappy about being there because it's such. Trust me, just from not even a football perspective, they have nothing like college, man. Wherever
nothing
you
like
go,
college. But even that, I say this all the time. It's hard to have to tell a kid, dude. Your career is over in high school.
Yeah.
Your career is over. Now, you will never strap up. You will never spat up ever again.
I tell y'all all the time, when I left high school, I had no intention of playing again. And it hurt because my boy was talking about, they got to go through summer workout. I was like, nah, man, I'm going to read a book or something.
Yeah.
they working out for football season. I'm like, I'm done, y'all. It's over. And it felt bad.
To look in the kid's eye and tell him, hey, man, it's over.
Yeah.
You done.
Yeah. That's
tough. Ass down.
But sometimes you got to look at what did you do.
Exactly.
All that time.
That's
caused that situation.
That's the
part. Let's recap your situation.
Before you go home and tell your mama,
yeah,
I don't like you.
Yep.
Before
you go there, think about your performance.
Coach didn't care about me.
I ain't care about y'all. I spent all this time with you.
You going around screaming Hail Mary. It's over, buddy. We'll be right back.
Coming to Tampa Bay, I said we want to win a Super Bowl, and I believe we will.
From IamSecond.com.
We came close, but never really did win that championship.
Former NFL head coach Tony Dungy.
At the end of my sixth year, I was fired, and it was one of the biggest disappointments of my life. Next year, I'm in Indianapolis, get to the playoffs, but get knocked out again. And for the next couple of years, it's the same thing. Everyone is saying Colts are never going to win one. And I did wonder, why didn't it pan out the way I thought it would? But I determined that I had to have Christ first, and that everything else came below that, including my own desires. The next year, that ended up being our year to go to the Super Bowl and win it. And it was a wonderful feeling. Every decision I make, I'm going to make it through the lens of Jesus Christ. And he guide us to that ultimate victory. I'm Tony Dungy, and I am second.
You do your thing, all right? Don't be nervous, okay? It's easy.
I'm just here so I won't get fined.
I say that to say this. If you wouldn't have did what you would have did, then we wouldn't have been where we was at to get what we got.
That just don't make no sense, dog.
It's The Crush on SSN.
Gonna put it out there. We're gonna see you do it. The Crush Recap brought to you by
Blunt Power.
With Blunt Power 3 Spray lasts for days. You can find out more about
Blunt Power
by going to their website, bluntpower.com, or going to their Twitter or Facebook page at Blunt Power. What you got for us, Mace?
Hey, man, we're gonna kind of wrap up with we've talked about, you know, the good, bad, the ugly of recruiting, but then it's a dark side also. You know, a lot of dishonesty out there.
A lot of it.
You know, I think a lot of time when we talk about these offers, a lot of people don't understand that colleges offer 300-400 kids.
Yep.
You know, yeah, you blessed to get that offer, but it's 200 other people who blessed to get that same offer.
Yeah.
And it becomes a numbers game.
Before you do that, what was your definition of offer today, what you told everybody? An offer is what?
Oh, nah, just, hey, man, it's basically empty promise. It's just like, hey, man, hey, we like you.
Yeah.
Exactly. Yeah, we like you. A lot of people don't understand, until you sign that letter of intent, it
means nothing.
Everything's still on the table.
Everything.
And it's crazy because the story, and we shared the story earlier, kid that was committed to Florida Atlantic, Lane Kiffin comes in, the kid doesn't have off anymore. It's a new scheme, it's new coaches, they don't know you. So right. They're not going to honor that offer.
Right.
You know, the same thing happened to Drake. Drake was a four-star kid. Committed to UGA. Rick got fired. Kirby Smart. Kirby done came in. Now Drake don't fit that system.
Mm-hmm. I had that same situation with my man Thump. Mm-hmm. Thump had an offer with Howard University. And then Mike London came in and said, that's not the type of linebacker I'm looking for. And we had to start over from scratch. So that happens. Yeah, you have to.
But you know what, the story we're talking about, the good thing about it is when you got a kid that understands his role, they bounce back real fast. And that was the good thing about the story. The kid still stays humble, still grind his grind on with his parents. Mm-hmm. Yeah. The dad was very involved in the process. And they were able to pick up another school, and he still signed. What did he sign at again?
I forgot where he signed.
But he signed with another school.
He did get a scholarship.
So he's still playing. Yeah.
But the process, though, it doesn't end to fit. The National Sign of Day.
That's it.
Right.
But that's when it starts, because you actually be able to put your...
Into April 1st. Paper.
Yeah.
Into April 1st.
The kid, Kahari Lane, the kid mm-hmm. from Macon County, mm-hmm. and we'll have him in like 2 weeks. We working out the logistics right now. But, I mean, it worked out for him.
Yeah.
He had offers. He didn't like his offers.
He held out.
He held out. He got what he wanted. Now, we'll see what happens from here. But, I mean, this is what recruiting is.
Yeah.
It's a dirty game, y'all. So much stuff is said. Man, yeah, man. Everybody recruit trip is the bomb.
And we had
oh, yeah.
You had B-Mac in here, and he said, how many positions? He said, we'll do 10 offers to get 3 spots.
10 offers to get 3 kids.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And you might not make it. I mean, that's how it is. But that's when, like y'all have always said, if you have everybody's involved. You got your coach in it. You got your parents in it. If something like this happens, you still can bounce back and go to a school that you want to go to.
Definitely.
Because, I mean, like you said, when Stump got that, well, how was his attitude?
Oh, he was ecstatic, you know. I mean, initially when he first lost it, he was a little upset about it.
And, I'm sorry, Thump. I ain't going to never mess that name up, Thump.
He was upset about it. And then we told him, though, you know, let's be patient. We're going to get back on the grind. We're going to send this film out. We're going to call these coaches. We just not going to quit. Mm-hmm. We're not going to quit. We're going to do everything for him. And he got what he wanted. But like you were saying, as far as the offers, and I want to tell every parent that the kids should stop saying, I tell my kid that, stop saying that you blessed to receive an offer. You should be blessed to be considered. That's
right,
what an offer
right,
is.
Right.
You are being considered to, you know, for this school. That's you're in consideration. Because that's why we talk to our parents about the situation. When, like we say, with our players, they'll have five defensive backs on the board. Now, they're looking at a lot of factors within those five defensive backs. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? So they're going to say, well, this kid got a better grade. This kid just a little bigger. This kid look a little stronger. You know, his home life a little better. We're going to take this kid. So now when it comes to real time, you know, the last line of defense, what we call it, meaning now, coach, what's the situation? Are y'all going to go ahead and try to sign this kid? Are we going to get that FedEx package? You know, that's when it gets real.
Right.
That's when it's real.
Because even if you go on an official visit, it's still not the real thing.
Right.
You know what I mean?
But think about how many people are on an official visit.
Absolutely.
And
absolutely.
Shout out to Coach Oglesby, man. He said coaches lied to get kids, and then before you know it, they have moved on to another job anyway.
And it's two or three staff. That's what happened at LSU.
Yeah.
But made everybody so mad at LSU. They held the running back coach just to make sure they got these kids in.
Yeah.
Signing day's gone.
And they
the kids committed. They fired.
Yeah.
I mean, let's look at Breon Dixon. He loved Trey Scott.
Right.
Yeah.
That was one of his key reasons he went out there. Trey Scott left North Carolina, came there, recruited the kid. The kid fell in love with the coach. The coach left, went to Georgia, and he said, it's unfair for me to be here, basically, you know.
Because that's the relationship that I had.
But see, you have to teach your kid, stop trying to be recruited just to play football. You got to look at the whole thing. I want to go to school for college. So, like with Will Poole said, I don't care if they leave or not. I want to be a Georgia Bulldog. I want to go to Georgia.
Amen.
You know,
Wendy say it all the time, man. If you're not playing football, would you still be at that school? And that's what it come down to.
That's the question.
Better love it.
And to add on what Wendy was saying, football is also the only one on the football field. It's the only one in sports. You're going to have to stay in college for a while.
Oh, yeah.
You know what I'm saying? You got to commit to this game. Footballers, they going to make you play. You know what I'm saying, man?
It's a commitment.
It's a commitment. So you better like the campus, the weather. The storms,
and you got to think past that weekend. That everybody's sitting it out.
Yeah.
They showing you all the good.
Yeah.
In a 48-hour window.
And that's why we talk about those unofficials. Just pop up on the campus and see what's going on every day.
Cause let me tell you something. You can tell who plays sports when you get on the campus.
Yeah.
Please understand. So all you got to do is be like, hey, dude, I'm from so and so. I'm thinking about, you know, I just stopped by. They gonna tell you.
Look,
they will tell you.
Me and Kobe Reynolds, we West Georgia invited us up there. Nice lunch.
Mm-hmm.
When we went to see the player work out, everybody say, "Bruh, nope, don't y'all come do it.
Yeah.
Don't even do it." These are the players saying that.
Mm-hmm.
I'm gonna listen to them. I'm gonna believe them.
Yep.
I don't care what coach in the talking about. All the players, I'm talking, every player was like, "Dude, y'all don't belong here." Oh, okay. And I talked to the guy who didn't play my position. Of course, the position guy is going to tell you that. I talked to, like, linemen, like, the white boy over in the corner. They're like, bruh, nah. First of all, they're giving a third of a scholarship up here. They ain't even giving people full ride. That's all I need here.
Yes.
We out the door. And the money shout.
Mm-hmm.
Nah, my mom and dad ain't paying for nothing.
Money shout.
But see, like I say, in the recruiting process, you know, we are not informing the parents on what's the real part.
They better get educated. Right?
What's going on in student affairs? You don't know. Because guess what you said? Every time my kid come back, you know, they say, Coach, Man, that indoor facility was so fire.
That ain't where you play. That's not where you play
ball. The locker room had air conditioning. I mean, my helmet stayed cool. Bruh. Okay. But what you measuring in?
I just thought about my helmet.
What are you going to measure?
Yeah, I don't want to do with this right
now. Yeah.
Throw the gloves up.
Put the gloves up.
Yes. But the sad part, the parents are in that too. Yeah. Because I don't think they, sometimes it scares me, and I've had arguments. Do y'all know what college is about? You know, you get books and you write and you do stuff like that.
Man, you got to do work.
You got to do schoolwork.
Yeah. Well, thank you, Coach, man. Hey, man, thanks to everybody in here.
Told y'all we're going to be fire today, man.
Thank you. Wendy going to come in with that fire hairstyle next week.
So straight from California.
Hey, man, check us out, man. It's just, you know, we all bad and bougie up here, man. We'll check y'all out next week, man. Make sure you good, man.
I'm good.
Hey, man, we'll talk to y'all next week. Peace.